How's it going, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. Although they are currently getting a break over All-Star Weekend, the Lakers will have to return to play without Anthony Davis on the court with them yet. And even when he does return, they likely will be very cautious with him up until playoff time. Because of that, they will need a third player to really step up and help take the load off of LeBron. While they haven't had a player do that yet with any regularity, we have seen the most potential from Dennis Schroder to be able to fulfill that role. While his offensive production has been up and down throughout the first half of the year, he has consistently been a difference maker for them both on offense and defense, and has the ability to have a big game on offense on any given night. And while he has been pretty good, for the Laker team to take that much needed step forward to become elite again, they need even more from Schroder. They need him to be that player that can lead an offensive unit like he was with the Thunder in the prior year, and he needs to do that nearly every night, not just here and there like he has been throughout this year. Again, he's been good, but not great on offense, and while that would be good enough for nearly any other team, for the Lakers who have championship aspirations, he needs to be great practically every night. To do that, there are a few things he needs to improve upon and do with more regularity. If he can do that, then I truly do believe he'll become the X factor for the Lakers to win another championship. In this video, I'll go over what I believe he needs to do individually to consistently make a huge impact on their team every game moving forward. And to begin, the number one thing I think he needs to do is become a more efficient 3-point shooter. He has been better lately, but right now he is currently shooting under 32% from the 3-point line. To play in a lineup with LeBron and AD, or even with only LeBron, the point guard in the lineup needs to be able to shoot the ball well from the 3-point line. LeBron draws a lot of attention, and to be a more effective off-ball player when he's on the court with him, Schroder has to convert more of his catch-and-shoot opportunities from the 3-point line. Schroder has a really tough role in this regard, as he has to switch between being a primary ball handler and an off-ball player all game long. When he is in the game with LeBron, he might get a play drawn up for him here and there, but more often than not, he's going to be on the wing without the ball, trying to free up more room for LeBron to operate. Oftentimes, LeBron will try to get to the rim and cause the defense to collapse, but because Schroder isn't a comfortable catch and shoot player yet, he often will pass up an open 3-point shot that a different player might take. And it's not that he isn't capable of being a good 3-point shooter, it's only that he hasn't ever really been relied on to be a decoy and primarily an off-ball player yet. And while he is a good playmaker and primary ball handler, he just isn't going to have that role over LeBron when they're on the court together. They obviously don't always share the court together, but for them to truly reach their full potential with a lineup of Schroder, Caldwell-Pope, LeBron, AD, and Marc Gasol, Schroder has to become a more comfortable catch-and-shoot player at times. However, lately they've been doing a much better job at putting LeBron and Schroder on the court together at different times, and they've done that a lot more lately because they've needed to without having Anthony Davis in the lineup. Schroder has been showing the ability to be able to run their offense effectively when LeBron is off the court and help them from falling behind when LeBron is out of the game too. However, he hasn't always been able to do that consistently either. At times, he'll look really good, and then other times, he'll look like not a good fit to run their offense. I think for him, it's more about getting comfortable doing it yet, as a lot of their offense was run completely through LeBron and AD the whole game before AD got hurt. Now, Schroder is being expected to not only be the primary scorer when LeBron is off the court, but also the primary playmaker too. I think it's something that he is definitely capable of doing, and if he is able to do it and become more comfortable in that role every game, then they will be in an even better position when Anthony Davis returns. Their offense before he got hurt while LeBron was off the court often looked very poor. It was pretty much continuous isolation plays between Anthony Davis or Schroder, and with an occasional pick and roll between Schroder and AD or Schroder and Harrell. Lately though, they've actually run a lot more plays without LeBron in the game, and it's helped them to get a lot more movement on the court. Kuzma has been a big beneficiary of this type of offense, as he's gotten a lot more open shots and has found his way to the rim a lot easier, and Schroder has a lot more room to operate as a primary ball handler because of it too. Finally, the last thing I think Schroder needs to do, especially while AD is out, is to continue scoring around 20 points a game. The Lakers haven't really had a player other than him who's shown to be capable of being a second or third scoring option every game. Kuzma and Harrell have contributed really well in their own way, but they don't have the same type of ability to be a 20 point per game scorer on a winning team that Schroder has. He can create his own shot whenever he wants to, and doesn't need a play drawn up to do it, or to be in a certain place on the court either. He can get to the rim whenever he wants to, he can pull up from the mid-range, and even hit a 3-point shot off the dribble too. And not only that, but he does it really efficiently. He's been shooting at 44% from the field this year, which is really good for a point guard, but he has the ability to raise that even higher. Last year with the Thunder, he shot nearly 47% from the field, which is very efficient for a point guard who takes a lot of shots from the mid-range. If he can get back to that mark again this year, while scoring around 20 points a game for the rest of the year, he will really help take a lot of scoring burden off LeBron, and he'll make them a much more difficult team to have to game plan against too when Anthony Davis returns. If you haven't realized it already, I believe there will continue to be a lot of burden placed on Schroder while AD is hurt, and even after he comes back too. He is 100% capable of improving in each category that I've mentioned thus far, and if he's able to do it, that is when they'll become an elite team once again. And not only that, but that is really when they'd be able to look like an even better team than last year's team. The Lakers became a dominant team in the playoffs last year when Rondo really became that third guy for them. He wasn't that for them during the regular season, and that is why many people doubted their ability to actually win a championship. But as soon as Rondo was able to fill that role for them, they added a whole new dynamic to their team on both ends of the court. Other teams were not game planning for Rondo to become playoff Rondo once again, and that is exactly what helped them to become an elite team. And that is exactly what Schroder is capable of doing too. He is capable of doing nearly everything that Rondo brought to their team during the playoffs. It's not only apparent in their similar height and build, but also in the way they play too. Both Schroder and Rondo take pride as elite two-way players. Schroder has become a very prolific perimeter defender for them and gives effort on defense every game, much like a younger Rondo. Along with that though, Schroder has very similar ability to get to the rim whenever he wants to and to really cause the defense to collapse, creating a shot for another player. Though, even though Schroder isn't the playmaker that Rondo is, he is a lot more capable of scoring the ball. Instead of being a liability as a shooter like Rondo was early in his career, Schroder is a threat from both the 3-point line and in the mid-range. He is a true 3-level scorer and can't be left alone wherever he is on the court. That coupled with his ability to defend at a high level like Rondo did for them during the playoffs can help him be the true X-factor for their team, and I believe he is the only player on their team outside of LeBron and AD that is capable of making that big of an impact for them, which truly makes him one of their most important players. But what do you guys think? Do you believe that Schroder is the X factor for them to win a championship? Do you believe that he'll be able to do that for them? Or do you think that he won't be able to fulfill that role and that added production will need to come from a different player like Kuzma or Harrell? Let me know by commenting down below and we can talk about it there. That'll do it for this video though. Thank you to everyone who took the time to watch till the end of the video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please remember to drop a like and to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and turn on notifications to get notified right away when I drop a video. But as always, thank you for watching and have a great day.